It seems like it's been a success so far. When will we know for sure?
Well, the Merge event definitely was a success. You know, the Merge is Ethereum's switch from proof of work to proof of stake. It's literally merging the proof of stake blockchain that Ethereum launched almost 2 years ago with the Ethereum mainnet. And we've seen that's had consistent block production and consistent finality so far. Everything's a success. I think what we'll see over time is, do the metrics hold up? Do we continually see nearly 100% participation? Do we see consistent block finalization and a healthy network in the coming weeks and months?
You know, looking out longer term, what are you going to be watching for? Are there any potential red flags that you are going to be looking out for?
Yeah, great question. You know, with these kind of upgrades, it's really important that Ethereum stays online, right? It's a really hard thing to do. But, you know, with these upgrades, they're also so complex, right? So there's a lot of things that could go wrong. We do a lot of testing. We make sure that things are working really well before we do the upgrades. But things we're looking for, right, is making sure liveness is continued. We still have the same uptime as before. One of the cool benefits of the switch of proof of stake is that it's a much smoother blockchain. Blocks are delivered in a more consistent fashion every 12 seconds versus probabilistically every 13 seconds. So really, we're just maintaining that the software stays online, that participants are staying online, that the network is staying healthy.
How do you know when this will be successful? Obviously, the price action today wasn't all that good. And, well, actually, it was down today. But you did see it rising very significantly until this point overall before we really hit the crypto winter. There was a lot of excitement around this. But when do you really see the benefits of the new economy of the system?
Well, we're seeing the benefits today. The switch is immediate, right? So the energy efficiency gain that we've realized, the 99.99% more efficient model is in effect immediately today, and the prior model immediately ceased. So we already see that benefit. We see the benefit of increased decentralization. There are way more actors in Ethereum producing blocks today. In principle, Ethereum's proof of stake is working now. It is successful now, and it's running smoothly.
You know, somehow pandas, Preston, have become like the signature meme of the Ethereum Merge. Can you explain that to me?
Well, it is a meme, right? So there's only so much I can explain here. But the idea was that we have like a polar bear and a black bear, and representing ETH1, ETH2, the two layers that are merging together. And apparently those two things make a panda. I'm not sure if that's a totally accurate in terms of science, but it is a fun meme and a thing we really enjoy.
What comes next? You know, this is very much, you know, a step in a series of more steps that will presumably give more people who are related to Ethereum lower transaction fees, faster transactions. But when do you really start to see that happen?
Yeah, the switch to proof of stake has really, you know, unlocked the next stages of upgrades. Ethereum still has a very ambitious roadmap and a very large amount of work to do in the next coming years. We see that there's already scaling through layer two technologies. And what we want to do there is to increase the security and data availability guarantees that Ethereum has. So what that means is to provide more data securely for things like layer two to provide that transaction scaling. And at some point we'll be also working on, you know, the idea about sharding and having more transaction throughput on the layer one, the base protocol of Ethereum. But really, you know, this is helping the switch proof of stake is really unlocking all these things and helping Ethereum become a global settlement layer that it aims to be.
Longer term, Preston, how do you think this could impact the broader ecosystem, whether it's, you know, in terms of just a lesson, the lesson that we see here, or the broader technology?
Yeah, it's a great question. I think that the energy efficiency of proof of work is rightfully criticized by many, and that may have been preventing developers from building on Ethereum and from participating in Ethereum's network. And now that that's out of the way, we can start to see more builders and bring on more developers and continue to build interesting decentralized applications.